Dobar dan, zavisnici od hrane, i dobrodošli u današnji vlog. Prvi vlog u Srbiji, a i u regionu koji se bavi sistema bezbednosti hrane. U današnjem vlogu govorit ćemo o digitalizaciji sistema bezbednosti hrane. I meni će se pridružiti u današnjem razgovoru gospodin Istok Colja koji dolazi iz Slovenije, kompanije More From Food, koja je osmislila jedinstveno softversko rešenje u oblasti standarda i sistema bezbednosti hrane. Danas govorimo kako implementirati takva softverska rešenja, koja olakšanja takva softverska rešenja doprinose ili donose našim sistemima i uopšte koliko to košta našu kompaniju. Dobar dan Istok i dobrodošao u današnji vlog Addicted to Food vlog.
I hvala veliki pozdrav.
I hvala ti mnogo što si prihvatio ovaj poziv da učestvuješ u današnjem vlogu. Tema je mnogo interesantna i jedva sam čekao da snimim ovako nešto. Već do sada smo mnogo puta razgovarali, ali evo, danas govorimo o softverskim rešenjima, digitalizaciji u sistemima bezbednosti hrane i ti kao predstavnik kompanije, odnosno CEO kompanije More From Food, si idealan u stvari da nam ispričaš ukratko o svemu i da nas upoznaš kako mi to da rešimo naše probleme i da ubrzamo naš sistem, da se rešimo tih papira i svega iz naše proizvodnje. Pa izvoli ako bi mogao za početak da predstaviš i kompaniju, čime se vi to bavite i odatle ćemo da razgovaramo dalje.
Vladimir, puno ti hvala na pozivu. Ovako, ova ideja rodila se 2017. Mi smo počeli surađivati sa Univerzitetom za veterinarske vede u Pizi. Ovako u Italiji treba svaki inšpektor da bude food inšpektor da bude veterinar po stroki, tako da od tada dođe sve znanje što se tiče bezbednosti hrane. Inače smo mi .com smo softverska kuća, tako da znamo kako se to radi. Ovako i ništa. Upoznali smo već da cijela industrija još piše sve na ruke, da 95 i više posto malih, srednjih i većih kompanija još upotrebljavaju papir i da pišu sve još na papir, tako da ovako, odakle se rodila ideja da treba neki softver da se svi postupki da su brži, da onaj koji je odgovoran da ima kontrolu na čime se radi i da i oni operateri koji moraju da neko stvar naprave da imaju ove remindere da ništa ne prođe.
Da to je...
se ništa ne zaboravi tako.
Odlična stvar. Istok, mi smo se već dogovarali za današnji vlog i ja znam da je neke karakteristične teme teško predstaviti moj jezik, tvoj jezik i tako dalje, da ne bismo imali tu barijeru, ne bi bilo loše onda mi u nastavku da baš kada budemo i pričali o softveru, pričamo na engleskom jeziku i svakako ćemo onda staviti i prevod neki tako da svi mogu da nas razumeju u regionu.
Puno ti hvala na razumevanju i ja se izvinjavam napred da neću baš pričati po srpski, ali trudim se kad se mi nas dvoje vidimo, pričamo po naše, inače kad ide za tehničke stvari, puno mi je lakše da po engleski.
Da, znam. I kad je u pitanju sam softver, iako on može da bude na različitim jezicima, ipak kada je na engleskom nekako zbog tih tehničkih stvari je možda malo lakše i zbog barijere. So, we can continue on English, yeah? Is that okay?
Yes, sure.
Okay, so it would be nice just to speak a little bit about experiences connected with the software solutions that exists in the company. So from my point of view, when I'm doing the auditing, when I'm doing some of the consultations, I can see that still, even though that I'm working 10 years in the food industry as an auditor or consultant, I can see that, you know, there were no big changes, you know, there were no implementation of some kind of softwares to speed up the process regarding the food safety systems. Of course, during the previous years, there were some implementation of the softwares like warehouse management softwares or the softwares for tracking of the production, for example, where through the softwares you can just check how many, you know, stoppages you had during the workday, during the production, etc. How many, how much time did you lose on some stoppages due to, you know, a defect of the equipment, etc. But till now, you know, I saw that there is a different softwares on the market. Still, I didn't had the real experience of some company really had implemented it. So it is a really my pleasure to talk today about this software solution. So I would like also that you share your experiences with the software development and implementation.
So short, starting maybe from your first point, I think the first fact is that probably the food industry is one of the lowest tech industries in the world, which means that food industry, when you talk about restaurants, when you talk about hotels, it's mostly about good food, it's about cooking, and it's not about technology that is behind. You know, this is the first fact. The second fact is also that also in larger kitchens, most of the people, at least in the previous year, were elderly people who are not able, actually, who don't use the telephone, who are not very familiar with technology. And now things are slowly changing also because the managers of this company are managers who are younger than 5 to 10 years before. And this switch is now coming to reality. For older people, writing on paper is still easier. But, you know, when we spend so much time, my generation, me too, so much time on phone behind computers that we don't even know how to write anymore on paper. So using a smart app, a smart device, it's becoming more and more user-friendly, more and more familiar to us.
Yeah, I know exactly the situation. You know, even in some companies using the electronic documents, you know, like the records in the Excel sheet or the records in some type of Word document, you know, it represents like, you know, totally different thing and the upgrade of the company. But on the other hand, I must say that if I look at all the companies that I have audited till now, I must say maybe 10%, and this is really big companies, are using even the you know, the Excel sheet to track and to analyze the system, to analyze the laboratory tests, to analyze the factory inspection results, audit results, etc. So I know that things are changing, they're changing slowly, and now there are more and more companies, you know, familiar with the software solution. But this software solution for the food safety is something that we are still missing in our everyday work, I might say. So I know that every implementation of the software needs time, development also needs time. And maybe the question is, and something that always gets frightened the people in the industry, you know, how much time will we lose on the implementation of this software? Is it easy? Is it user-friendly? Is it how we can say, maybe from your point of view, how much time do we need to implement it?
Okay, I can give you an example. Let's say of a catering restaurant here that just purchased our system 1 week ago. We it took us 1 day to implement the system with which means all the suppliers, all the materials, all the checklists, everything. And then I was surprised when I went to the client, and the owner is actually a 30-year-old girl, and I was amazed how fast she got into the system. I was there probably 20 minutes. I explained her everything, and she didn't call me yet in terms of things she wouldn't know how to do and stuff like that. Maybe, as I said, probably for the younger generations, it's even easier, and probably because also our software is made for dummies, which means that it's easy to use. And also the app is very user-friendly. We spent a lot of energy by doing that. Of course, not no software is perfect, neither is ours, but you know, we try to think of it as a Tesla car. You know, today you have one car, tomorrow you wake up and your car has a bunch of new implementations, functionality implemented overnight. And this is how we try to work. This is how we try to function. Also, that's why we don't charge our clients when they need some additional, you know, functionalities that would benefit the whole, let's say, community of our users.
Okay, that's perfect. But I know from some experience regarding the implementation of any software solution, you first need to have the system set up. You first need to understand your processes, maybe have already some procedures, etc. So you already have something implemented and then you just transfer it. And it's much easier. It is not time consuming when you understand your system, your processes, and then you just transfer it in the software and speed up everything, you know, lose the paper and everything. So with the implementation of the software from the experience, what are the benefits for the customer?
So first of all, you get rid of all the paper, which means that all the entries, everything, all the data that you input inside the system is at one click, which means that if a food inspector comes and needs some data from 3 months ago, you don't need to go into paper files. It's just there. Second of all, putting entries inside the system, it's much, much faster, as I showed you on the, maybe we can show it also on the video later, how it works. Yeah. So as you saw, and I will explain later, it's really, really fast. And third, the system gives you a bunch of notification, means that if you forgot to do something, you will get a notification on your phone that something needs to be done. And fourth is the temperature, automated temperature monitoring of fridges and refrigerators, which is also a big plus, especially for systems who have many, many fridges and refrigerators, which means that, for example, in average, the checking on one fridge takes you 1 to 2 minutes a day, which means that if you check it twice per 10 fridges, it's 20 to 30 minutes each day in the average.
Okay, perfect. So actually, if I understood good, we can cover the cleaning aspects, the checklist for the cleaning, getting the notification for the operators when it's time for the cleaning, and then we have the records from the finished cleaning. We have the records from the recording the critical control points, recording of, laboratory analysis, also the recording of the temperature. But in the temperature cases, we have also the some sensors that we can put in our refrigerators, and then we collect data from there. So till now, I have met one company that has this software, you know, just for the collecting of the temperature. That's it, you know. But in this software solution, we have like all package. It's there. So if we say, since this is the software for the food safety systems, for the standards, can we say that with this software we have the solution for the HCCP, for the ISO 22000, even some maybe stricter standards like IFS or FSSC?
Yes. So the software is based on ISO 22000, on a prerequisite of ISO 22000 2018. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't only include HACCP, but also other standards like BRC or IFS can be implemented. Actually, we have a client in the UK who is a gluten-free meal producer for airline companies, who is also BRC compliant. So yes, the system was born from the beginning as a very wide in terms of possibilities, which might frighten some clients. But you know, all the functionality can be limited just to the ones who a client needs. So it doesn't only have food safety management, but it also have training of employees. It also have a very powerful tool of audit for auditing and risk analysis and so on. So yeah, it depends on the type of industry that you work for or that you are in. And then it depends which functionalities are you willing to use within the system.
So we might say that the use of the software could depend from the size of the company, of course, from the number of employees, and also the simplicity or complexity of the processes. So this would mean actually that maybe if I'm a small company, let's say to 5 employees, I could use this software just to have maybe to digitalize my checklists for the cleaning, for the reception, for control of the critical control points, maybe pest control, let's say 5 of the checklists, to remove it from my production and just have it like in the software. So this could be also the model. But if I'm really big company, I can implement also the supplier evaluation. I can also implement the internal audits, audit of the supplier, and all other specific topics maybe that are a little bit complicated than for the smaller company.
Yes, food traceability as well. So as you said, if you are a restaurant owner, or maybe you have 2 or 3 restaurants, and you don't want your employees to cheat, this is the perfect solution for you, because the system doesn't allow you to cheat, because you can maybe, if this is set, so you can choose another date, but you know, the date of recording stays in the database. So you cannot lie on what has been done, basically.
Yeah.
And maybe I can show you a quick example of
that would be perfect.
Food safety plan for one restaurant, just very quickly.
Okay. Let's see how it works. Okay,
so perfect. I'm clicking on the app, and as you can see here, I have the list of the checklist that I need to perform on daily, weekly, and so on. So as you can see, the app also gives you notifications. I deleted them before, so there are that because I entered the app already. But as you can see, let's say that this is an example of a daily cleaning, and this is the checklist. As you can see, this is very easy. So you select date. This is one surface, sinks, grill, coffee machine, floor, toilets, kitchen. You can add some comment if you want to. You put your signature and you complete the task and the job is done. Let's say you have a weekly evidence, and it's the same principle. So I'm going to clear the data again from the app. Okay. So the weekly evidence. So this is the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Tuesday, first Friday, and Saturday, Sunday, and the task is complete.
Yeah, it works very fast.
Yes. Then let's say we are monitoring fridges. So this is the refrigerator in the kitchen. You go and you check your temperature and it's 2 degrees. You go to the next fridge, refrigerator, pantry. It's 3 degrees. Next entry, and so on until the last refrigerator. If you have delivery, okay. And again, you have something delivered today. Now, you select the food group, whether it is chilled, frozen, ambient, or dry, and then the system automatically recognizes which materials are related to which food groups.
Mm-hmm.
So this supplier we have for these food groups, we can enter the temperature. It's 2 degrees by delivery, compliant, confirmed, job done. Let's say we have two probe calibrate the probes when needed. Again, measure temperature, it needs to be 0 degrees. So let's say corrective action, no problem. You can also have instructions here. So which means that if you don't know how to do something, the process check is commented. So you confirm it or you complete the task.
Yes. But generally, when we talk about every of these records, we can, in the background of the software, input all the data that we need to verify during the, for example, the reception, not just the temperature. Maybe we need to verify the cleanliness of the vehicle, the shelf life of the product, etc. So we could set up all the questions in the background.
Absolutely. Let's say, I was too quick again. Let me just show you again how another task could be performed. Let's say in UK they call it kitchen walk around, okay. which is something that you do once a month.
Okay, it's like the factory inspection or something like that. It's mainly done once per month and yes. To check all the things, infrastructure and such.
Yeah, it's like a small internal Audi, let's say. So this okay. is the kitchen walk around, and here we have the question: did you observe any problems or did the same issue
occur? So just you need to share it.
Okay. So again, we have this task, kitchen walk around.
I'm sorry, it is still not sharing. Okay, it's sharing now.
So we have this task, kitchen walk around. So this is the first question. Did you observe any problem or did the same issue occur in the area 3 times or mm-hmm. more? Yes, no, no. Next entry. Have you reviewed your safe method? E-methods, yes. Next entry. Has the allergen information been updated to reflect any mineral ingredient test changes? Yes. And so on. And all these tasks that you can see are mm-hmm. absolutely... let's say not invented, but you can maybe to say it in another way, each user that we create comes within an empty platform, which means that all the procedures can be implemented based on what is already in use or what is the current procedure on a client. So the system is 100% customizable. Basically, okay. doesn't have any limits in this
perfect.
Way.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect. And we also mentioned that all the software can be on different languages. For example, if it's implemented in Serbia, it could be on Serbian language. So it is also customizable.
Yes, absolutely. So for now, perfect. We have translated it in 3 languages. And also the app is supported by the native language of the user, which means that if the user is logged in inside the platform with let's say English, he will also see the English version of the app. If he's logged in Italian, he will see the nice. Italian version nice. Of the app.
Yeah. Perfect. Okay, great.
So quickly about our app.
Well, it looks great, you know. Especially when you go through it this fast and you just check it, like there's a cleaning, click, 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 it's finished. Perfect. It's perfect. I also like a little bit of the design and everything. So, my only question here is, this people that works in the production area, the operators, they would need to have a little bit of knowledge using the phones, the also the application to click it, etc. It is very simple. It doesn't need from them to enter, to type in or something. They just need to click it and that's it, especially when it's cleaning. But have you struggled with this in the companies where you implemented also about, every change starts with the rejection?
Yeah, people would like to the things stay all the same, just 5% better,
Yeah, yeah.
So, as I said before, basically younger people are very happy when they receive such a solution. Of course, if somebody is not used or doesn't even have a smartphone, this could be a little bit an issue, yeah. Mm-hmm. For like mm-hmm. users that are 50, 55 plus, we had this experience with Sodexo in Slovenia, and this implementation took a while because, some workers were, let's say, older than 50 years old and also low education and stuff like that. So yes, in these cases, I have to be honest. You know, using a smartphone if you don't have any could be a problem. But for people like me and you and younger, this is a great welcome.
Yeah, well, I know from my experience that when I worked for a big retail company, when we implemented the software that we have developed internally by ourselves, for example, just for the auditing of the retail stores, just for the tracking of the laboratory analysis, we have succeeded to, you know, increase. For example, in previous time, we audited just one store per day, and we could increase with these to even five smaller stores per day. So it was you know, like really not losing the time on writing the reports and everything was automatized, etc. And also what was perfect was that during the audit we had like time needed to check all the analyses, what happened, what are the most common non-conformities, etc. We have like 7 minutes to take all of this data from 360 stores, you know. So it was like in 7 minutes you have all the data. What are the biggest non-conformities? What are the non-conformities that were closed through some corrective actions, etc.? So it was really something magnificent. So I know that this software would help a lot of the companies. And one important question that I know everyone will ask, you know, the price, especially in our region, or how do I pay it? What is the price? Is it paid, you know, monthly, licensing, etc.? How it works? Can you explain it just shortly and maybe give some example?
Okay, so our software is location-based. In terms of licenses, which means that we don't charge per user, but for us, the user is the location, which means that one restaurant, one license. Of course, if we implement the system in a larger production where a lot of data are stored, you know, also storage of data is also expensive. So we normally charge per department, but this is only implemented in really, really big systems. Otherwise, one store, one retail store, one bar is one license, and prices start with 79 euros a month. And the more licenses you buy, the lower the price.
Okay. So it means that expenses are charged per month on licenses or per year?
Well, it depends, you know. If you want to pay yearly, you get an additional discount.
Of course. That's what I wanted to know.
Yeah,
you know how these questions works. So that's it.
Of course, it's legit.
Okay, Istok. So thank you very much for explaining all of this. I know that you know, we can talk about this like for hours. I just wanted to ask you for one additional thing, maybe just in future to make. I would like that we make one webinar maybe where some participants can also come and maybe just ask direct questions to you, just to explain it, because this would be the people from the industry, and just they can ask directly what are the solutions, how they can manage it, etc. And I'm planning to organize that. And also one additional thing for this, you know, very ending, just maybe to say that we realized our cooperation regarding the software More From Food, and that from now on people can go to addictedtofood.me and just check also the website and additional data about More From Food. They can contact me directly also, and of course both of us together can explain to people how this works, how software is implemented, and really show them some demo versions.
Thank you very much, Vladimir. Much appreciated.
Thank you also, Istok. I hope that this situation with the COVID will soon be finished, and that we can maybe arrange seeing each other in live, maybe in Belgrade or I don't know, Slovenia or whatever. If everything.
Yes, I've been to Belgrade last time 5 years ago, and I cannot wait to come back. I love Belgrade. It's a beautiful city.
So Belgrade. It is. Okay, thank you very much, Isto, for this. And I hope that you will join us next time when we organize a little bit of webinar with some participants to talk a little bit more about this really, really exciting software solution.
I would be really glad, Sto. I'm looking forward for your invitation.
Thank you.
Thank you, Vladimir.
Bye-bye and take care.